tearing up in the southwestern. Here are comrades. Enjoying my cup of coffee. Watching the sunset. After a day's work. Let's take a look at our finances. Alright. We got the new livestock today. We bought some chickens. We had some construction costs with the chicken pen. And I believe something, a couple other buildings. I did a land purchase of $184,984. Production cost was $36,785. Sold products, $417,732. The water cost for the animal pen for the sheep was $90. It'll probably go up to $92. Possibly. Harvest income was $36,921. Miscellaneous costs was $94,798. And we have in the bank account, we made a profit today in the month of December, $72,388, with a bank account of $249,309. And we are moving into January of the next year. I got 54 hours and 40 minutes play on this map so far. We got work tech, we got 17.99 acres plowed. Total. We're probably going to make a couple more fields to reach up to the goal of 21 acres for one simple reason. That's what I was born and raised on, a little micro farm, 21 acre farm. And we've got a couple more buildings and a couple other things that I need to place down yet. And January, the weather report says snow in the forecast. But right now, at the moment, present time, it'll be dropped down to 19 degrees at 4 a.m. On January. It says 18 degrees. That would be at 3 a.m. Okay. We got, like I said, we got snow in the forecast. I don't know what we're going to do here just yet. And I'm fixing to go lay down and get some rest. Think about what I'm going to do for the month of January. In the morning. Okay. It's January. And Sally needs her food bill. What I would like to see in the next version of Farm Sim, to be able to name your dog for one simple reason. A lot of farmers would love to be able to name their dog on this game. I'm willing to bet, I'm sure of that. And possibly pick a breed of dog. She's doing very well. She likes to ride along with me on the tractor. Let's get cracking. First things first. We've got a greenhouse to take a look at. Alright, where are we at on this greenhouse? Alright, we got seed, water, solid fertilizer, herbicide. Not too bad. The only thing I have running at the moment is sugar beets and cotton. The crops production facility, we need to put seeds back in it. Alright, let's drop this tanker real quick. Seen here. See if we have any more seeds stored away. I hope so. Yes, we do. Cool. Alright. Now, if you recall, I think it was episode 6. 5 or 6, somewhere in there. I have a blue screen. But anyhow, I said something about forestry work. There is a little greenhouse mod on Mod Hub. It's called the Wood Production Mod. I've missed out on two great demands. Furniture so far, because I didn't do any forestry work whatsoever, or have a sawmill. Now this mod, let's bring it up the menu here real quick. It's called the Wood Production Mod. And what it does is you put water, seed, manure, slurry into the production part of it, and it'll grow your trees and act as a sawmill at the same time. You get wood plank slow, wood plank fast, and your trees grow at a different rate. All at a rate, it says fast and slow. I don't see what the slow means. Just water and seed is the slow part of growing wood. But the running cycles is 3,960 cycles. The fast, I guess it's due to the fact you add manure or slurry. I guess it makes the trees look grow a little faster. I'm not sure on how that mod works. I do have a carpentry set up, which accepts woods and planks. And I have furniture in the process of being made, storing the wood chips. Back down here, we are distributing the wood and planks to the carpentry shop. Alright, my multi-fermenter, I have it in storage, 525,753,000 liters of silage. I was converting some potatoes and grass into silage. Now, next one is sugar, the sugar mill. I had placed a sugar mill. Rusty Money talked about being on this map once before, doing a Baker's Dozen challenge. Well, guess what, Rusty? While we're doing this 200, I will do that baker's dozen donuts, and I will distribute send you a whole bunch of donuts. I got some eggs. I need to get some flour started. I got some wheat, I got some barley, and I got some oats, and I got some sorghum stashed away from this little nice neat mod here, which needs seed at the moment. What it does is it produces wheat, straw, barley, oats, sorghum, canola, soybeans, corn, sunflowers, potatoes, sugar beets, sugar cane. Now, speaking of sugar cane, I can't plant sugar cane. Well, I could, but I'm not going to go through that struggle. And cotton is not on this here at all, but it does have all the other base crops except the cotton. I don't know if it was missed or there was a reason behind it. All depends. Well, anywho, let's get some seed. Into that little production pot. I did a little bit of terraforming right here. If you could come up into here like this, head toward this crops production area. Beans that need seed, we will put seed in there. That should last a little bit. All right. I got a couple products I gotta get out of this thing here to start with. All right. So what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna store my seed in the silo over here. Let's go up here and take a look at our weather forecaster. Okay, according to this, it says sunny for January. I don't see no snow in the forecast. It must have got changed. Wind speed direction is 2. It's northwest by the looks a thing at 2 mile an hour. That's good. Then it's gonna change in the afternoon the direction wind speed. 2 all across the board. Not too bad. Expected high for January is 43 degrees. green ass over here with this cotton in it. It's one simple reason. There is not a piece of equipment that's under 200 horsepower on the PS, on the console side of things to harvest crop. That's why I chose this particular greenhouse, due to the fact none of the cotton pickers are under 200 horse. And I looked on the mod hub and everything everywhere else to see if there was a tractor pulled cotton picker, and there's no such animal. That's why that greenhouse is sitting there like that. Take the sugar cane to the sugar mill. Another production here. We got that back up and running. We want to take a look at our grass dryer. Where are we at on that? All right, I got 247,000 liters of plus of grass in here fermenting into hay, and by the time it's done, I should have half a million of hay. So what then, therefore, when this is done, I will place a cow pen, and I will have, all I need is a mixer to make my TMR for the cattle. I have the feed all ready to rock and roll. I just need to make the silage. I mean the TMR. Where are we on with our eggs? Let's take a look. How many eggs do we got here? Oh, we got 478 pieces in here. Can we pick it up? Sugar. All we need is some flour now. Didn't have to place a flour mill there somewhere. It's not going to be a big one. Oh, myself a building to put all my equipment in. Terraform. Great. Alright. Let's grab some wheat, barley, oats, and sorghum. Let's get a supply started. We're gonna put the flour to distribution. Are you serious? I already got that in there? How? How's that possible? I just placed it. I'm confused. Huh? think I have that set for distribution. I'm pretty sure I don't. That's all in storing. We're gonna have to check something. Pretty cool, neat, neat to see. So if I put all my grains in here, well, first of all, let's not do that. Now let's see something over here. Sorghum in over here, that mill would have access to that sorghum. So if I put sorghum in over here, and I run out of sorghum over here, it would draw from that silo. Interesting. Okay. That was supposed to be for the chickens. I'm gonna have to pay attention to that. I really don't want to move that flour mill. And to answer everybody's burning question on this map, if you mow the grass, it does regrow back. Nope. sort of in here. Because I have noticed that the 2,763 liters we get and 10,114 liters of barley in that silo over there, which this has access to. Soybeans is still growing. The canola is still growing. And sunflowers are still growing. Right. I'm going to go across the street for that. See what we've got over here. Alright. That's 10,114 liters of barley. Over here, we got 13,000 here. Okay, the silo doesn't have access to the stuff that I put over here. So what I put over here will not register over in this silo. But if I put anything in that silo that's related to making flour, it's going to pick up that silo and use it. Right now, we're going to activate all four. Alright, they're all run the oats, and sorghum runs at 1,200 cycles per month, the barley runs at 600, and the wheat runs at 3,600. So it should produce pretty fast some wheat. Now, what's, we already know the donut shop has eggs and sugar. Takes 2 eggs, 3 sugar, and 4 flour. And once we get enough flour in there, we'll start making donuts. And we are going to make the Baker's Dozen Challenge on this map. That's like killing 2 birds with 1 stone. Rusty, I'm doing your challenge. Oh, before I forget, I would like to thank everybody that has supported and subscribed to my channel and so forth. I have reached a stepping stone. I now have 401 subscribers. And Benji and Alan are both knocking at the door. Give me a moment. Come on, Benji. Kitty will get it. Okay. I put this wheat in the flour mill. Messed it up. Sunflowers, potatoes, sugar beets out of there. I hear a train. I'm not gonna run out there and do that. No. Probably not anymore. Thank you. We are going to deactivate the beats. Out of space. So that all that's left is caught in the greenhouse. I do have a sugar mill going on, and price of beets. Oh, this is the month for beets. January. Cool. Looks like we're going to be selling some beets here later on. Alright, what are they offering? Okay. Crustus is offering $775 per 1,000 liters. The sugar mill I own, so I'm not going to get no money from them. Now the tubers is offering $791. Do I want to make the run up the hill to get the extra dollars? Yes, I will, for one simple reason. I need to put fuel in this tractor. Shoes on, Venti. We'll be going here in a minute or two. Get to take this load up to the to the roots area. And Alvin, you were just disrupting the whole situation. Crazy yellow fuzzball. Alright. Well, cruise control. Go back through there and see what's all back through there. No, there's a bunch of forestry. Sunflowers doing fantastic. All right, we need to sell this load of root crop beets to the roots area. I've got some seed fertilizer sitting there. I can possibly put it in this wagon. Set there. Alright, let's see what we get for our beans. We're selling 24,500 liters of beans. And we are at 119,406. Will we get a bonus? $19,395 off of that, so that brings me to a game save. Alright, we're still in the negative for the month of January at 96,000. That will change eventually. Hopefully by the end of the month, I should be in the green or white, whatever you want to call it. Still no loan. I'm not allowed to have a loan, so therefore we will do it the right way. Alright, how's my sheep doing? They could use a little bit of food, but they're doing good. They're 4 months. And it won't be long. They're halfway there. On the puberty side of things, now I did buy my chickens. I did buy them at full-grown chickens so they can reproduce. I needed eggs straight away, so that's what I did for that. And, of course, I got a rooster here that's 1 month old. Happy boy. Alright. Let's go over to the gas station. Put some fuel in this tractor. We do have a header up here. I need to build a storage area here soon for all my equipment. Let's see how much it's going to cost us. Alright, $87 to fill that tank back up. While we're here, I'm going to repair it. And before we repair it, I gotta pull out my trusty pocket hose, attach it to the faucet over here, clean my equipment. So I can see what I need to repair. Oh, those hooks on there. More tarp. And we don't have a tarp for it. Thank you. disconnect our pocket hose, put it back in our pocket. Let's do some repairs. Alright. Okay, on the tank right now. I'm not gonna paint it. I am gonna need to repair it. Had to make a couple adjustments on the brakes. Repair work here, we had that. We did it, it was in 3 months. We have had this for 3 months. We need to do an oil change and a couple of things. That's gonna cost us. Cost was. Should show it in here. Total running cost so far has been $1,808 for those three pieces of equipment right there. Just a mental note. And I know we've got another tractor down here that needs some work done to it. Alright, while we're here, let's grab fertilizer. Time to get something to eat. Breakfast. There went the sign. Well, that's gonna cost me to have that back. There we go. Let this trailer back up for a while. See if it'll fit in over here. I didn't take it all, but some of it. The engine off. There we go. down the hill. Needs repair. While we're there, might as well.